Hello, beautiful people. Happy Monday. Hope you had a fabulous weekend. I'm Dr. Trina Hinckley from The Expanded Self. Just popping on today to share with you my ideas about how hiking is like life. So I popped a blog post up this morning which talks about this. So I just wanted to natter about it really, and I hope that you get something useful out of it. As it occurred to me a really long time ago that carrying a big pack up and down steep, slippery, treacherous hills is really a lot like life. We start off, we get out of the car, we're all excited. Think about it like the beginning of a day at work perhaps. And we chuck our pack on, or if we're going to work, we put our clothes on, our appropriate outfits, our makeup, our ties, whatever it is that we're wearing, and off we go. And generally in the beginning, it's not too bad unless you've been a bit silly and chosen one of those adventures that starts like that to begin with. But most of the time, you know, we might walk along a nice little path for a while, and maybe we've got a view of the river, maybe we've got a view of a ridgeline somewhere, you know, whatever it is, there's usually something for us to look at and something for us to be entranced by. And so too in life, that, you know, when we start our day or our week, whatever period of time you want to look at, there's stuff for us to pay attention to, there's stuff for us to put our energy into, and hopefully that's not too much of a challenging start to the day or the week. And then we progress on for a little while. Maybe there are some little ups and downs, you know, maybe there's a little bit of a climb, but it's not too bad. Maybe you feel like you're breathing a little bit more heavily at some point, but you get your breath back pretty quickly. And so too in life, where we might feel like there are a few challenges, like maybe we have an argument with our partner, maybe our boss does something that we really don't agree with, or one of the people who reports to us does something we don't agree with. Just life goes on, little ups and downs like that. Maybe we have a few victories, finish a project we were working on, get a bit of a view off the side of the mountain we're climbing up, something like that. And then there sometimes comes a point where we look up and we go, holy cows, that actually looks pretty tough. And we might stand there for a while and debate whether or not we want to take on this challenge. Maybe we don't have a choice. Maybe we're partway up the hill and there's no car where we left it. Perhaps we got dropped off and we have to continue. So we take on the challenge with our pack on our back, our trusty poles in hand and our sturdy boots on our feet. And we trudge up the hill. And it's hard. It's really hard going. Our pack weighs us down. Our arms feel exhausted from using our poles to try and drag us up the hill. Our legs are getting heavier and heavier and heavier. And add on top of that, the hill's actually muddy. So with every step you take, your boots add another few grams to them. Now that doesn't sound like a lot, but this is a big hill and you're taking a lot of steps. So a few grams every step actually adds up to a lot of weight. And there's some saying that for every, I think it's an American saying, so excuse the units of measurement. I think it's something like for every pound on our feet, it's equivalent to 5 pounds on our back or something like that. So a little bit more weight on our boots from a little bit more mud is actually a lot to carry. But we keep on going because that's the choice that we've made, because we don't have an alternative. Whatever the reason, we keep on going. And then we get to a little point where it's a bit flatter. We can stop, we can get our breath back. Lean on our poles for a while. If you're anything like me, that's, you know, quite heavy leaning on our poles, going, trying to get our breath back. So giving an opportunity for a little bit of replenishment in that moment where there's a bit of level of ground. And so too in life. We might be dragging ourselves through the week. We might be unwell. And if you're unwell, I hope you're home in bed, really. we might be facing some quite large challenges in our lives. And we keep on going. But sometimes there's opportunity to rest, and it's really important to do that, because that's what allows a little bit of self-nourishing to replenish, to fill your cup, to fill your tank, to fill your wallet, whatever analogy you want to use, a little bit of self-nourishing to replenish so that you can keep on, because you know that what's coming ahead is going to continue to be challenging for a while. Stop, rest, look after yourself, then load up again and start going again, climbing the mountain again. And maybe up ahead, there's a point that's so challenging that you actually have to take your pack off. And I've had a few of these in the past. Maybe you need to use a rope to haul your pack up, because maybe you need all your arms and legs and as little weight as possible to actually scramble over something that's quite challenging and potentially a little bit treacherous. And it's okay to take your pack off in those times. You know, some of us tend to have a little bit of mentality around, oh no, I have to carry the whole weight the whole time. Well, it's okay to let go of the weight sometimes. It's okay to let go of the burden sometimes, knowing you have to pick it up again, but it's okay to let go of some things. So you take the pack off, you tie the rope to it, you get through the really challenging bit. And then when you're through it and you're stable and you've had that little bit of recovery, you pick the pack up, you grab the rope, because you tied it around your waist so you wouldn't lose the end, you grab the rope and you pull the pack up. And so too in life. Maybe one of your children is unwell and needs extra care. Maybe they're just having a particularly hard time at school. Maybe there's something really challenging going on at work. Whatever it is that's happening, if it's a really big challenge, it's okay to gently and carefully relieve yourself of some of your other responsibilities for a while. Maybe that means that your partner cooks dinner for the next week or two. Maybe it means that your partner looks after the children a little bit more for the next week or two. Maybe it means that the personal development courses that you've signed yourself up to need to be put on hold for a little while. Maybe it means that you need to take a couple of weeks off work and look after yourself or your children or your partner or whoever it is. And then when you've had time to recover, replenish, nourish yourself just a little bit, deal with a big challenge, pick up your other responsibilities and keep on going. So up the mountain, pack's back on, you've recovered your breath, all's good. You keep climbing, even though your boots weigh a ton from all the mud, and eventually you get to the top. And you look out across the range that the mountain's in that you've been climbing. And the view is spectacular, just spectacular. And this is where you need to take a moment to celebrate. Maybe you sit down and be really extravagant and pull your billy out and make a cup of tea. Maybe you just sit there and enjoy it. Maybe you have a little meditation on the top of the mountain. Maybe you dump your pack and there's a little bit of a scramble that you can go up without your pack and enjoy a little bit more view and come back down again. Whatever it is, take a moment to celebrate what you've achieved. And so too in life. When you've got through that really challenging thing, when you've finished that project, when you've moved house, when you've relocated your children in a new school, whatever it is, take a moment to celebrate, to acknowledge yourself, to reinforce your abilities to look after yourself. Because you know next you've got to go down. Or shortly you've got to go down. For a little while you get to walk along the ridgeline and you get to enjoy that beautiful expansive view. and all those gorgeous mountains. And you get to bask in the sun because you're above the clouds just for a little while. And you know at some point you'll go down. When you get to the descent, and you can see that it's pretty shaly, it looks pretty slippery, maybe it's difficult to navigate. You use your poles or any other resources or tools that you have that you need to help you, and you start the descent. And at some point, you might fall and you might injure yourself. And that's okay. Take a moment if you fall to check out your body, check out your feelings, make sure you're okay before you get up and start going again. And when you think you're okay sitting there on the ground, take a moment to stand up and just test your legs and your arms and your poles and any other equipment you're using and make sure it all still works and it's all okay. And then take a few gentle steps before you start hurtling yourself down the hill again. And so too in life. Sometimes you'll stuff up. Sometimes you'll make a mistake. Sometimes something will come along to trip you up. That's no consequence of anything that you've done. Take a moment to reassess. Take a moment to have a breath. Feel into what's going on. Re-establish what you need to do before you start going. Have a look at where any gaps are that you might need to address and then start going. And as you navigate your way down to the bottom of that mountain on that slippery slope, when you get there, you set up your tent, light your fire, and it's time for self-nourishment. And maybe this relates to the end of the day, the end of your week, the end of your month, whatever cycle it is. These are life cycles. Stable and easy. Toughen up but achieving something. Small ups and downs. And a big descent every now and then. Allow yourself the opportunity to enjoy it. To enjoy what life offers you, what it brings you, and to learn from it. I've learned so much from hiking. I've gained so much strength and courage from hiking that I can apply to my everyday life. And lessons that I've learned on the trail that serve me well in everything I do, which is why I think hiking is such a strong analogy and metaphor for life. I hope this has given you a few things to think about, a little opportunity for reflection at this time where COVID is growing in Melbourne and many places around the world. It's timely for us to stop and reevaluate what our lives are like, what's going on for us, and take a moment or two to reflect and to consider what do we really need to be carrying in our pack. What is it that we're carrying? Are we actually strong enough to carry all of that? Do we have everything that we need? I think many of us, many of you listening and watching, could probably pop in a little bit more around self-care and self-nourishment, a little bit more self-love. Maybe take out a little bit of self-criticism or perfectionism. Or compulsiveness, or obsessiveness, or endless scrolling on Facebook. Just take a moment to consider and reevaluate. Have a great day, great afternoon or evening whenever you're watching. And I'll connect back in on Wednesday with a little bit of a different video on Wednesday. I might do it as a live this week. And then there'll be the regular Friday meditation. So Have a great few days and I'll connect with you again soon. See ya. Thanks for watching.